Hello children, we shall discuss a new lesson. Before going into the lesson, let us see the style sheet. What do you see in the picture? We see high technology where a girl is learning something on computer. And what do you see along with the picture? We find reading A, the fun they had, reading B, written pretext poem, reading C, the computer game. Now turn the picture. Turn the page, children. What do you see on the face sheet? You see a robot, a rocket, a digital classroom where learning is done with laptops and digital board, and astronaut is moving in space. After seeing the picture, you are supposed to answer the questions given in the textbook and practice with your friends. The skill of debate on development in science and technology will always lead to disaster. We can say that we are going to know something about science and technology and its change with respect to this lesson. Before entering into this lesson, let us know about the author of this lesson. Isaac Asimov, 1920 to 1992, was an American author best known for his science fiction. He was a professor of biochemistry at Boston University. He is considered the master of science fiction. Most of his works explain scientific concepts in historical way. He worked as president of AHA, American Humanist Association. He earned a credit on Star Trek, a movie on science fiction. His famous works are the Foundation series, the Robot series, and the Galactic Empire series. Before entering into the lesson, children, we shall have a glance at hard words of the lesson. Crinkly, with many folds or lines, awfully, very badly, unpleasantly. Million, 10 lakhs. Telebooks, books seen or read on a television or computer screen. Attic, a space just below the roof used as a storeroom. Scornful, contemptuous, think something is worthless. Slot, a given space, time or position. Pattered, hit repeatedly. Disappointed, upset. Geared, adjusted to a particular standard or level. Loftily, in a superior way. Regular teacher, a mechanical teacher. Betcha, I'm sure. Dispute, disagree with. Screamed, gave a loud cry. Probably, likely to happen. Nonchalantly, not showing much interest. Beneath, below. Mechanical, connected with machines operated by power. The fun they had is a very, very future story. Usually we say once upon a time, but this story is very, very future one, which is going to happen in 2157, and in which there are two characters, Maggie and Tommy. Maggie, who is 11 years girl, Tommy is a 13 years boy. They are brother and sister. These children finds a real textbook on attic, which was very old, which was a wonder for them, and it was the time at the time of their great grandfathers, and the story revolves around the book. Now let's read out the lesson. The fun they had, Maggie even wrote about it that night in her diary. On the page headed 17 May 2157, She wrote today, Tommy found a real book. It was very old book. Maggie's grandfather once said that when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when all stories were printed on paper. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly. And it was awfully funny to read words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on a screen. You know, and then when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had had when they had read it the first time. Let me give you the meaning, children. Here, Maggie opened her diary and wrote dated 17th May 2157. She wrote that day they found, they means Tommy as well as Maggie, found a real book. That was old, very old book. Maggie's grandfathers once told her about a real book. When he was little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when all the stories were printed on paper. That means even Maggie's grandfather also read and wrote on e-books only. They do not know about the real books and pages. The children were very much excited and thrilled to see the book. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly, and it was awfully funny to read words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on the screen. When they turned back the page, they found the words as it is. It was exciting and thrilling too. And they read the book for the first time. "Gee," said Tommy, "what a waste. When you are thorough with book, you just throw it away, I guess. Our television screen must have had a million books on it, and it's good for plenty more. I wouldn't throw it away." "Same with mine," said Maggie. So she was 11 and hadn't seen as many telebooks as Tommy had. He was 13. She said, "Where did you find it?" "In my house," he pointed without looking, because he was busy reading. "In the attic? What's it about?" "School." Maggie was scornful. "School? What's there to write about school? I hate school." Maggie always hated school, but now she hated it more than ever. That mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography, and she had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head scornfully and sent for country inspector. Tommy said, "Maggie, what a waste. When we are thorough with the book, we just throw it away. Whereas our one television screen must have had a million books on it, and it's good for plenty more." "I wouldn't throw it away." "Same with mine," said Maggie. She was 11 and she hadn't seen as many books Tommy had seen as he was 13 years old. Maggie asked the boy, Tommy, "Where did you find this?" "In my house," he said without looking at her, as he was busy reading the book. "In the attic." "What's about it?" she asked. "It is about school," Tommy said. He was scornful. "About school? What's there to write about school? She puzzledly asked the boy. Maggie hated school because these days her mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography. She had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully and sent for the country inspector. Here, inspector means not the police inspector. He is the inspector who looks after the education department and the computers, who actually sets the speed of the computers and repairs the machines. He was a round little man with a red face and a whole box of tools with dials and wires. He smiled at Maggie and gave her an apple, then took the teacher apart. Maggie had hoped he wouldn't know how to put it together again, but he knew after an hour or so, there it was again, large and black and ugly, with a big screen on which all the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. That wasn't so bad. The part Maggie hated most was the slot where she had to put some homework and test papers. She always had to write them out in a punch code. They made her learn when she was 6 years old, and the mechanical teacher calculated the marks in no time. The inspector had smiled and patted Maggie's head after he had finished. He said to her mother, "It's not the little girl's fault, Mrs. Jones. I think the geography sector was geared a little too quickly. Those things happen sometimes. I have slowed it up to an average 10 years level. Actually, the overall pattern of her progress is quite satisfactory." And he patted Maggie's head again. Maggie was disappointed. She had been hoping they would take the teacher away altogether. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month because the history sector had blanked out completely. So she said to Tommy, "Why would anyone write about school?" Coming to details, children, the inspector was a round little man with red face, and he appeared with a whole box of tools with dials and wires, and Maggie smiled at him and he gave her an apple, and he taken out the computer teacher away. Maggie hoped he wouldn't know how to put it back, but he knew how to put it back. After an hour or so, it was again large and black and ugly, big screen on which the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. This part was not very disappointing, but the part which Maggie hated the most was the slot of homework and test papers, where Maggie had to write them out in a punch code, and it has been done by her when she was 6 years old, and right from the age of 6 years old she has been doing the same. And the mechanical teacher calculates the marks within no time. After repairing, inspector smiles at Maggie and he says to her mother, "It's not the fault of girl, Mrs. Jones. I think the geography sector was geared a little too quickly. Sometimes the things happens. I have slowed it up to an average 10 years level," he says to Mrs. Jones. Actually, the overall pattern of the progress is quite satisfactory, and he patted Maggie's head again. Maggie was disappointed. Why? Because when Tommy's teacher was in repair, it took almost 1 month for its repair, and she expected the same with her computer also. As her computer took no time for its repair, she was disappointed. Hence, she said to Tommy, "Why would anyone write about school?" Tommy looked at her with very superior eyes, because it's not our kind of school, stupid. This is the old kind of school that they had hundreds and hundreds of years ago, he added loftily, pronouncing the word carefully, centuries ago. Maggie was hurt. "Well, I don't know what kind of school they had all that time ago." She read the book over his shoulder for a while, then said, "Anyway, they had a teacher." "Sure, they had a teacher, but it wasn't a regular teacher. It was a man." "A man? How could a man be a teacher?" "Well, he just told the boys and girls things and gave them homework and asked them questions. A man isn't smart enough." "Sure he is. My father knows as much as my teacher. He knows almost as much, I betcha." Maggie wasn't prepared to dispute that. She said, I wouldn't want a strange man in my house to teach me." Tommy screamed with laughter. "You don't know much, Maggie. The teacher didn't live in the house. They had a special building and all the kids went there. And all the kids learned the same thing. Sure, if they were the same age. But the mother says a teacher has to be adjusted to fit the mind of each boy and girl it teaches, and that each kid has to be taught differently. As the children of the future do not know the concept of the present school concept, they were discussing how the schools would be, and they were trying to understand the concept of the school. When Maggie said, "Why would anyone write about school?" Tommy looked at her with very superior eyes, because it's not our kind of schools, stupid, he said to the girl. And it was the old kind of school, some hundreds years ago. The concept of school was different, he says to the girl, and added loftily, pronouncing the word carefully, centuries ago. For which Maggie hurts and asks, "What kind of schools they had at that time, long time ago?" And she read the book over the shoulder of the boy. "Anyhow, they had a teacher." "Surely they had a teacher, but wasn't a regular teacher." They were discussing. "Yes, yes, they had a regular teacher, and it was a man. And how could a man be a teacher?" They were once again confused. "Well, they said to each other, the teacher used to teach girls and boys all the things, gave them homework and asked them questions. A man isn't smart enough." They got a doubt. "Sure, my father is as clever as our teacher," boy says. Maggie says, no, I don't want a strange man in my house and teach me in my house." For which Tommy says, no, teacher won't come to our house and teaches us, but there will be an
a different place where all the students sit and learn the things, that is nothing but a school, and the teacher teaches all the students, and children of same age will be made into a class.
Just the same, they didn't do it that way then. If you don't like it, you don't have to read the book. I didn't say I didn't like it, Maggie said quickly. She wanted to read about those funny schools. They weren't even half finished when Maggie's mother called. Maggie? School. Maggie looked up. Not yet, Mama. Now, said Mrs. Jones. And it's probably time for Tommy too. Maggie said to Tommy, can I read the book some more with you after school? Maybe. He said nonchalantly. He walked away, whistling the dusty old book tucked beneath his arm. Maggie went into the schoolroom. It was right next to her bedroom, and the mechanical teacher was on and waiting for her. It was always on at the same time every day except Saturday and Sunday, because her mother said little girls learned better if they learned at regular hours. The screen was lit up and it said, today's arithmetic lesson is on the additions of proper fractions. Please insert yesterday's homework in the proper slot. Maggie did so with a sigh. She was thinking about the old schools they had when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy. All the kids from the whole neighborhood came laughing and shouting in the schoolyard, sitting together in the schoolroom, going home together. At the end of the day, they learned the same things so they could help one another with the homework and talk about it. And the teachers were people. The mechanical teacher was flashing on the screen. When we add fraction 1 by 2 and 1 by 4, Maggie was thinking about how the kids must have loved it on the old days. She was thinking about the fun they had, by Isaac Asimov.
Students will have the option of reading or not reading the books. Listening to which, Maggie said, I would like to know more about the schools, she says. They started reading the book. Meanwhile, their mother called Maggie school. Maggie looked up and said, not yet, Mama. Now, Mrs. Jones said, probably it's time for Tommy too. Maggie said to Tommy, can I read the book some more time with you after school? Without interest, he says, maybe. And he walks away, whistling, tucking the dusted old book under his arm. Maggie goes into her room. It was right next to her bedroom, and the mechanical teacher was on the was waiting for her, and it was always on at the same time every day except Saturday and Sunday, because her mother said little girls learned better if they learned at regular hours. Hence, it was very boring for her. The screen lit up as usual and it said, today's arithmetic lesson is on the addition of proper fraction. Please insert yesterday's homework in proper slot, asked the computer. Maggie did so with a sigh. She lost in thoughts of olden schools, of her great grandfathers. All the kids from whole neighborhood came laughing, shouting in the schoolyard, sitting together in the schoolroom, going home together at the end of the day. They learned the same things so they could help one another with the homework and talked about it. And the teachers were people. All the things were remembered, and she was very much thinking of all the things. Meanwhile, the mechanical teacher was flashing on the screen. When we add fractions 1 by 2 and 1 by 4, Maggie was thinking about how the kids must have loved it. In the old days, she was thinking about the fun they had in the olden day schools. This is very beautiful story written by Isaac Asimov, assumed by him, about future schools. Children, go through the exercise given below and do the worksheets, children.